My name is Jamila Mayanja. I'm the founder and team leader of Smart Girls Foundation Uganda, an organization I started in 2012 that empowers and mentors young girls and women, also in my free time when I'm with my son and husband. So I'm always on cartoons, watching what, SpongeBob? Yeah.
You know, growing up as a little girl, my grandmother always reminded me that this is a man's world. Every time she had a chance, in very many different ways, she always said, by the way, this is a man's world. So in my house, putting on trousers was a woe. You can't put on men's clothes. How do you wear men's clothes? Huh? My name is Mary Luswata. Welcome to a Women's Day special. This is Salon Talk. And you know, the salon is mostly for women. Well, these days, even men spend more time in the salon. But if you're the kind of man who likes to have your hair done, okay, that's just wrong. But yeah, if you want your hair done, if you want your nails done, if you want anything done, please come by Spectra Salon and Spa. We are in Bugolobi today, and I'm having my nails done. As always, this guy, Frank, does amazing, amazing manicure. And you will find very many other guys here who will pamper you, will give you foot scrub. There's at the exfoliating. There's so many things. Come by. If you are not this side of town, please go to our branch in Kabalagala. And if you happen to be around Makindye, there's also another Spectra Salon around there. Like I said, it's a Women's Day special, so it's just ladies on the show today. And first of all, you're all looking amazing.
Thank you.
You had your makeup done here, right?
Yes.
Mula batemba gamba, simba wuyimbi, kano sikalango. Ebintu byeraga. So before we go any further on the show, I want to have some introductions. Please, what's your name? What should I call you?
You can call me Annette. My name is Annette Katende, and I'm the CEO and founder of We Can Do Ja, Women's Business Market.
We?
Women's Business Market.
No. The name of the market?
We Can Do Ja.
We Can Do Ja. Oh, yes. We Can Do Ja. Ah, the way you said it. You remind me of a radio presenter in this city. I won't say name, but there was this ad running, and she used to say, Yolom Dadai. Yala mtadai. Yala mtadai. Kombe yolo mudidi. Mutu isabubi. What's your name?
My name is Nambi Treasure Liz. You can call me Treasure Liz. Yeah. I'm a medical doctor at hospital.
Oh. I respect doctors in Zebiagana. Biade ma. Nasigala mubi akogera. Please introduce yourself.
I'm Namtevi Irene.
Yes.
I'm a counselor by profession from Clinic One Degree.
Oh. I need to shut up. The profiles on this show. Please the first hadjat on my show.
Hello.
Please introduce yourself.
I'm Jamila Mayanja. Yeah. I'm the founder and team leader of Smart Girls Foundation Uganda, mm-hmm. that are partnering with Ann to bring you the Women Business Market.
Hey, and you have an amazing voice. Have you tried radio?
I wish.
You should.
They should hire me.
No.
XFM,
not
big class.
No one in this city, you should hire me. You walk into a place and say, can I speak? Exactly. Now you've had my voice, can I get hired? That's how I go to this job, Strobo Mania. So we're doing our Women's Day special. And like when I was doing, introducing the show, my grandmother always said, this is a man's world. Before we go any further, is this a man's world?
Definitely no. This mm-hmm. is not a man's world.
This is not a man's world.
This is a world that incorporates both women and men. Mm-hmm.
So why are we getting our roles mixed up lately? Why are we trying so much to be men and not just appreciate our position as women, as naturals, as flowers? We blossom, you know, through the horns, but we are with thorns rather. But we are trying so hard to put on trousers. Okay, well, not literally, but we're trying to wear the pants. In our relationships, we're trying to wear the pants in our homes. We're trying so hard to wear the pants, and which is okay, but we're trying to take the pants off the men.
Because, you know, society gets us there.
Mm-hmm.
You know, women who have men abandon them with 12 kids. Mm. She has to put on those pants to mm-hmm. fit those kids because mm-hmm. the good guy mm-hmm. is not going to take up his role.
The good guy.
So we Watch need them. To, we end up trying to get up, wear those pants mm-hmm. and survive in this hard Uganda.
Yeah.
Yeah. But the fact is, we both have hands and legs, so we need to also get into this. It's not a man's world.
It's not a man's
world. We all hustle the same way.
So before, one thing for sure, one thing is clear now. This is not a man's world. If you are the kind of person who is thinking the traditional way of, Banange, let me tell you something. One of the questions that I am so tired of being asked is, when are you getting married? Do I have to get married to, do we have to be married for us to have a position in society? Do you have to have a man on your side for you? Do you have to be a Mrs. something for you to matter in this society?
No, you don't have to be married. You don't even have to be in a relationship. You don't have to have a man by your side to be important.
Yes.
To be considered important. You can be anything you want to be and just a woman, a single woman.
But you see, the problem is, you say it here, I hear it, but when we leave this place, every woman, no matter the education, no matter how strong-minded they are, and it's going to eat her all day. All day.
Well, I think having a man is just a nyongeza. It should just be a nyongeza. He should just come and help me out. Because clearly we can exist and do these things on our own. But we need, you need that partner. You need someone to laugh with at the end of the day, someone to talk to, someone to share. Have children with, basically.
Yes.
But to be honest, it's not a man's world, and we can all survive in this world. And what to add on what you said, that we have to wear the pants these days, because we have grown up in homes where there are single parents.
Yes.
Mainly, as in, especially this in this day and age. So at the end of the day, you grow up seeing a strong woman doing her thing. So you grow up and you know you don't need a man to survive. You don't need, you don't need to beg for something for you to exist. Like you said, you walk into a radio station and you speak and you tell them, can I speak?
Oh, yeah.
Exactly. So I walk up into an office and I'm like, can I sell you this? At the end of the day, someone is buying and I'm making my little monies.
And then they say, oh, I'm a kazi. Let me tell you, the next time a taxi driver is going to say, oh, oyavuga mukazi, I will park that. I will get out. And I will remind you that you came out of a woman. And that I can, let me, I am tired of this belittling us. I am tired, and please don't get me wrong, I am not a feminist. I don't even understand feminism. And maybe one of you will help me understand feminism, or later we'll talk about what it really means. I'm not a feminist, but I don't believe in being belittled. You don't say, and I'm not the only person who feels that way. Have you heard that
the
say
funny
to you?
Thing is, Abasaja bavuga bubi. Badly, not even like, okay, he will try and pass you because you're driving slowly, but maybe you're just driving the way you're supposed to, and
because you road are safety a woman.
Exactly.
We're not competing with you.
Exactly. You're not rushing to go anywhere. You're just being weird and angry, and an angry person. At the end of the day, honestly, there's some men that actually drive. Now you understand?
Yeah,
you know, in our organization, we train girls to do mechanics. So one of the girls, after their graduation, walked into our garage and tells them, I want a job, I can be a mechanic.
Wow.
They laughed so hard. Aww. They couldn't believe it because she was a woman. But when she got down to do what they were doing, they gave her utmost respect. So I think with our society, when you prove to them that they can, we can do even much better, then they start to think, So, kati wabavuka wubi, they should think like twice.
So we're just introducing you to most of what we're going to talk about. You realize it's just not really specifics. I'm just touching on this and this. So if you are in the kitchen, or if you're driving back home, or whatever it is that you're doing, because we can do what men do, yeah? If we, whatever you're doing, you're at work, come closer to your TV, you know, put the volume on loud, and let's do it as women, because this is our day and we're celebrating it, and we're celebrating women, we're celebrating motherhood, we're celebrating being a natural, and we are celebrating being our own, not necessarily trying to compete with you, because we cannot, even if we ever try, we can't compete with you. That's why we are special in our own way. In fact, we are even more special. Men don't want to hear this. Men don't want... Yo, I was on this show once, and I told, I was having a conversation, and I said, the men, like men I meet, and they say, oh no, wafuna kusento, oh no, tasoboka. Oh no, what, everything, all you have to do is make sure, oh no, takusinga nga kusente, oh no, make sure that she doesn't have a job. Oh no. And these are men who are saying this thing. So I am somewhere in a corner and thinking, really? How old are you? And well, there are men in their 50s, men in their 40s. Nembagamba nandi bavumyo busiru na ye. Let me just respect you for that. Do you honestly think that a woman working is a bad thing? Of course you're women, but you're not going to think it's a bad thing. But the way we've interacted with these people and the kind of passion they speak with, waxing up sent to you, is there anything wrong with having more money than a man?
There's definitely nothing wrong with a woman having more money and working. Like, this woman is going to work, she's going to add on something onto her family, she's mm-hmm. going to support the family,
yes,
support the kids, mm-hmm. buy day-to-day things. Mm-hmm. Yeah. So I think women definitely have to work. That saying of men feeling like women should not work. Namuleke waka, muleke la sente za kameza.
That's
really. Yeah. Women have to get out
and
there and work.
You even ask yourself a question. Do you know the price of meat? You've left money at home. Yeah. It won't buy meat. But you want to come back. You want to find meat. You want to find her because she has cut the children. Do you want to find your own children in the saucepan? What is this?
No. To make it worse, then he comes back. He sits, then nakugamba mpereza remote, mpereza maulire, jamwe ngato, mwana wakaba, then amazi emere foku jangu ndi, sabula kugamba jangu I swallow.
Mutu tama, mutu isabubi, and we'll talk about a lot more when we come back. Like, that was just breaking the ice. There's a 5 women on this show. Mutu sabula mwe. Use the hashtag Salon Talk if you want to get in touch. If you've been raised in a home where a woman is everything, share. Celebrate women. Let's celebrate women. Let's celebrate us.